We'll hear a little bit from Jim Rome, Shared Beliefs owner, in just a bit. But before that, I want to tell you about an amazing sign-up bonus we have if you don't currently have a TVG account. Bet $50, get $50. It's as simple as that, but you absolutely must use the promo code CLONES50. Now, if you like Shared Belief, but you're not loving those 9-to-5 morning line odds, we have something special just for you. We're giving TVG account holders an odds boost on Shared Belief from 9-to-5 to 5-to-2. That's getting $7 instead of $5.60 day of. It's something you do not want to miss out on. Make sure to use your mobile device, though, and bet on Friday. Now, without further ado, let's get to Shared Beliefs owner, Jim Rome.
Talk about racing this week as regards to the Breeders' Cup Classic. You got Your Horse Champion, two-year-old, taking on California Chrome Derby and Preakness winner, taking on the Belmont winner in Tonalist. How is that for racing the week leading up to the biggest race of the year in North America? What do you think it's going to do for the sport?
You know, it's great. It's great. And I think the thing that this sport needs, and I hear this all the time, and I know you talk about it as well, how do you make horse racing what it used to be? How do we go back to that glamour era when everybody loved the sport, or there was so much recognition about the sport? And you've got some work to do. One of the places to start is with rivalries. It's hard because these horses do not have the careers in terms of longevity that other athletes have, where you get connected to them and rivalries. They go to the breeding shed, they get hurt, they're gone. I think what we're seeing this week is we're seeing some really good rivalries. Shared Belief and California Chrome have never even run, yet there's an established rivalry. You've got the East Coast, which does not really respect the West Coast all the time.
Correct.
And they're talking their junk about us. So you've got the likes of Tonalist coming back and Toast to New York. So we've got these inherent rivalries. The California horses, the East Coast, the West Coast, the big names, the stars. I think that's all really good for the sport.
And trainers, Jerry Hollendorfer, unique man, Hall of Famer. Who would you compare him to in pro sports?
Bill Belichick.
Hoodie?
Bill Belichick, he's the hoodie. I see a lot of the same in him. I mean, Jerry's funny. He plays it very even keel. He doesn't get too high. He doesn't get too low. He doesn't give you a lot of information. He's a pro's pro. He's very modest. He's not going to let you in. I mean, he looks to me, he's a more personable Bill Belichick.
Shared Belief. Let's play the if you were a human athlete game. Who would you compare him to?
You know, I've made the point that I think that he's Russell Westbrook. I think he's basketball Russell Westbrook because he's freaky, he is athletic, he is explosive, he is quick, he is smart. He just doesn't have that wacky wardrobe that Westbrook rocks.
But he can pull it off, though.
He could. And you know, like Westbrook, he's not that big, but he's intimidating because of his skill and his explosiveness.
So do you stay out of the way, Jim, following up on that question? You let Jerry do the training, call the shots. Do you have any input?
I stay the hell out of the way.
Yeah.
I stay the hell out of the way. I mean, it's nice to be asked, but if they don't ask me, I'm not asking why I'm not being asked. I know my role. You know, I've learned this early on. The horse people make the horse decisions. We might be the majority owners, but we're talking about a Hall of Famer. Jerry Hollendorfer is the Hall of Famer. He's the general. He is in charge. Alex Solis is as sharp a guy as I know. He's our race manager and bloodstock agent. So to answer your question, I stay the hell out of the way. I like to be informed, but I stay out of the way.
You know, Jerry Jones coming down to the sideline.
No, I'm not down the sideline. Yeah. And by the way, how does he get to the sideline that fast?
What's your experience leading up to a big race like this? How do you take it?
It's a long, long week. You know, I got kind of some like nervous energy where I want to call Alex Solis again, but I know he doesn't want to hear from me. And he'll take the phone call. It's a long week. I'm glad that I've got a lot of work to do this week to help me spin the clock.
Your family, Janet does, and your kids are into it too, right?
They love it. They love it. My 9-year-old Logan will watch race replays with me. And I think, frankly, he's blown by me. I think the kid knows more about the sport than I do at this point. My older boy, Jake, he likes it. He's into it. He wants to put on a suit and come to the Breeders' Cup. Janet definitely is a fan. But yeah, it's kind of neat that the whole family now is into it.
So come 6 p.m. Saturday night after the Classic. I mean, you've achieved more in racing than some people who own countries have in the last 6 or 7 years. What's going to be the plan going forward and the goal for Jim Rome and his family in horse racing now you've won the Breeders' Cup Classic, if you do?
Yeah, that's such a big if. I'm not assuming this at all. I mean, that is, we've never been in a race like that. That is going to be a tough, tough, tough race. I can't even imagine. I'm not even going to let myself think, well, what happens if you win that race? Let's run the race first. You see, I become Belichick. I become Hollendorfer.
Right.
I become Solis. I can't even allow myself time to think about what I would think or do if we run that race. I can't even speculate. Honestly, it's so far down the road. Winning a race like that is an absolute dream. I can't even imagine.
Post position 6, by the way. Got to be happy with that.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. I'm not going to lie to you. There were some nervous moments as that draw was coming up, and all those inside slots were still right there. But Alex and I spoke before, and I said, what do you want to be? He said, anywhere from 4 to 10. and six came up, and I think that's a good spot for him. You've got speed on one side, you have speed on the other side. I think that if he breaks well, he should sit a pretty nice trip. So we like where he is very much.
Good post position. Hopefully he won't get the same type of trip he got in the Awesome Again. We'll just touch on that before we let you go, Jim. The Awesome Again, you weren't there at the track. You had other commitments that day.
Well, I watched it, though.
Did you? Did you watch it live?
I watched it live.
What did you make of that?
Something else I learned in this game early, it's a man's game. This is a man's game. This is a nasty game. This is a tough game. And we've got a horse that's a two-year-old champ who is undefeated. He's got a bulls on his back now, so, you know, we're all big boys, like Jerry said.
Cheap shot, do you think?
I think there was some race riding involved, and I'm all right with that. You know, and I think the other thing is, I'm going to look at this as a positive. We learned a lot about our horse that day. I think it was easy for people to say, yeah, he's fast, he's athletic, he's good, but he's never been tested. He's never had any adversity whatsoever. Let's see what happens to that horse when he's in a real dogfight coming in. And I think that you probably could not have found him much more adversity than we found for him that day. And we saw the way he responded. That dog will fight. That guy will go. And I think we learned a lot about him. And I don't have a huge issue with him having a race like that, even before the big race, because now we know what we have.
I'm with you there. I think good horses overcome adversity, and I think great horses do, and he overcame it that day. I read somewhere Baffert called you, Bob Baffert, the next day.
He did.
To say those instructions
weren't from him. Yeah, he said, he called me, and I saw it, and I was in the middle of something, and I didn't take the call. And then he called right back, and I was still in the middle of something, and I didn't take the call, and then he called right back. I mean, he was determined to find me. And he said, Jim, it's Bob Baffert. I said, what's up, Bob? He said, just so you know, I did not tell the jockey to do that. I said, you didn't? He said, absolutely, I did not tell that jockey to do that. I said, you didn't tell your jockey to push us halfway to the parking lot? He said, I'm telling you, I didn't. And you want to know what? I believe him. I believe him. I accept that. I think that he did not tell that jockey to do it. I don't really know what happened or what went on, but I want to be real clear about this. I do not have an issue with it. I mean, that's racing.
Right.
It's a man's game. Our horse overcame. Whatever it was, and I don't know what it was, it didn't matter. Share belief on that race.
Well, Jim, we wish you the best of luck this weekend. Thank you for your time, and we appreciate it as always. Best
of luck. Always good to see you, Simon. Thanks very much.
Thanks very much, buddy.
You got it.